right. Wow. Good evening, huh?
Good evening,
good evening ladies and gentlemen. My name is Zane Guzelderly, and welcome to BSU Late Night. Shane McGuire will not be here with us tonight, as he is with the family and friends of the four who passed away in a tragic accident last week. Brian, on the other hand, was going to host, but after a quick glance at his contract, we noticed that if Shane is not in the studio, Brian has no right to step foot on the premises. And after the Teamsters helped him into the unmarked black van in the alley behind the studio, my co-host, Richard Rogers, and myself were thrown into this situation.
That's right.
I am not Brian. Right you are, Zane. Why don't we start with the traditional news roundup?
Sounds good.
Yep. It's been reported that the hair of Justine Bieber, in which was...
No. That's Justin. The pop icon?
Oh. Okay, didn't...
That makes a little bit more sense,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah. Really look of it that
All
way.
All right.
All right. Well, he recently chopped off his hair during a salon session, and it's actually making special appearances around the country, along with some other exhibits.
Okay, what are they?
Such as Miley Cyrus's bong.
Okay,
for salvia,
all right.
Jonas Brothers' purity rings.
Mm-hmm.
And Michael Jackson's nose. And it actually is cupped in the icy, damp hands of Liz Taylor.
Really?
Yeah.
A Liz Taylor joke now.
Well, I mean, do it while the odors are still there.
Okay, well, I know she enjoyed a good laugh, you know.
Yeah.
In Fort Myers, Florida, a honor student was allegedly arrested after pistol whipping her mother.
Pistol whipping?
Pistol whipping her mother in order to get a sports car. Now, this incident is bringing light to the phrase that most honor students are living by.
And what's that?
If the grades don't do it, the butt end of a pistol will.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, it could happen to anyone, pretty much.
It shouldn't. It really, really should not.
Well, okay. Well, you know, I don't know if you've heard, but a Montana Radio Shack is actually offering dish packages with rewards of either a free pistol or a shotgun.
Okay,
yeah?
All right.
All right, but there's more, okay. If you refuse the two of these items, you also actually do have an option of getting a $50 gift certificate to Pizza Hut.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's not really on the level of the other two, but okay.
Yeah, you know, but no matter which reward that you choose, pistol, shotgun, or Pizza Hut, someone is going to end up dead.
That is true.
Yeah,
and you're on the money
true.
With that one there.
Right.
Now, as many of you may have heard, there was an Egyptian cobra that escaped from the Bronx Zoo earlier this week. Oh, yeah. Now, zoo officials, they took the necessary procedures when they found out.
Yeah.
But let's be realistic here. Have you been to the Bronx lately?
Yeah, it's not so nice, really.
It's not. I'm more worried for the snake's life, you know?
You know, you do make a good point right there.
I mean, a lot of stuff has happened at that zoo, you know?
Yeah. Such as, like, for instance, 20 years ago, like, nobody really made such a fuss when that big elephant escape from the Bronx Zoo.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but I guess nobody really made a fuss because she went on to make a name of herself. I think it's called Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, I didn't know she's from the Bronx. That's
yeah,
cool.
Well,
good for her.
Yeah.
Good for that elephant.
Yeah.
Openly gay internet blogger and overall annoying person, Perez Hilton, has a new book coming out. No, he's got a new book, and it will be a children's story.
Oh, he's not made enough friends that he's reaching out to children?
Well, the children's story will be entitled The Boy with the Pink Hair.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, and because this book is, apparently it had a really hard time coming out. because apparently they couldn't agree on a title, which brings us to our top 10 list of the week.
Oh, yeah, okay.
The top 10 alternate titles to Perez Hilton's children's story. Richard, why don't you start up
okay.
Number 10.
Will do. All right, number 10, Zane. And to think that I saw it on Castro Street.
Number 9, Moby Dick.
Number 8, Bieber Fever. I'm liking that Ellen haircut.
Ooh, nice. Mm. Number 7, Green Eggs and Men.
Number 6, Rice-A-Roni. It's not the only San Francisco treat.
Number 5, Oliver Thrust.
Number 4, The Chronicles of Narnia, coming out of the wardrobe.
Oh, okay. Number 3, Where the Wild Things Are.
Number 2, Horton Feels an Ouch.
And the number 1 alternate title to Perez Hilton's children's story, The Cat and Drag. That is right, The Cat and Drag. Well, we will be right back after these messages, and Jordan has an interview with some zombies.
Zombies?
Now we're going to see what that's all about, so stay
goodness.
Tuned.
What has this world come to?
I don't...
My name is Buck, and I'm here to represent the people of Muncie, Indiana, and I'm also here to talk about the importance of Ball State University and how we can revenue, something about revenue. What's a word for increasing revenue? Increasing, I'm gonna use that one. We wanna increase revenue here on Ball State's campus, you know? So what's a major problem at this university? The bell tower. The bell tower. The bell tower. I first came to this campus in the spring of 2003. I stepped onto this campus and I said out loud, "This place is a piece of shit. I mean, you got a bell tower coming out of the middle of the road. I mean, how many people have hit that bell tower while they've been driving? None? You better check again, you know. I hit it driving in this morning. I was driving along, and all of a sudden, the all-female jogging team was on the side of the sidewalk driving towards me. And like a trance, I didn't look where I was going. I'd been drinking, too. I shouldn't have been driving, but, you know, my driver has typhus, so. You know that the female platypus has 7 vaginas? Yep, I didn't know that. It's terrifying. Is one the right one? See, part of the Salisbury legacy is that we know where there are hidden oil caches all over the United States of America. My father knew this. He knew this several years ago. He surveyed areas all over Indiana, parts of Nevada, California, even parts in Puerto Rico. He was there for the hookers, but he found oil too. Anyway, we found out that underneath the city of Muncie, Indiana, is a giant oil cache. So I'm here before, you know, the word spreads and everyone comes with their ideas to talk about what this university can do. We cut out the bell tower and we put in an oil rig. I know, that's what I said too. And they're going to go for it too. You can put billboards on it. And, you know, we thought we'll put a giant digital clock. Well, analog clocks take me 23 seconds to read. You think you got the time, and then the minute hand twitches, and then you're like, well, I'm lost, you know? So I think if we put a digital clock on there, there'll be less accidents, right? So picture an oil rig coming out McKinley Avenue, you know? And then, you know, class is starting at noon, right? Little beeping going off. Little oil shoots out, you know? And the children can dance in it, and we'd make a festival, you know? I'm just thinking of all the smiles on the little kids' faces, you know? You ever see inner-city kids when they play in a fire hydrant? It's the same idea, only the problem is it might kill you over overexposure of the oil. You see the Pelicans after the BP crisis? Which you don't know if my name was attached to that oil rig. My company built it. We just put it off on Halliburton because, you know, everyone hates Halliburton. Dick Cheney's gonna, you know, he's gonna about to go.
All right. Welcome back. Yes. Okay. As we said before we left, Jordan has a very interesting interview with some alleged zombies. So, Jordan, what have you got for us?
All right. Thanks. I'm here with it's Lenny and Brad.
Brian.
Lemmy with an M.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Two, actually.
All right. So, you guys do this human versus zombies thing, right?
You could say that, yeah.
How do you sleep at night, knowing that people are dying in this game?
Quite comfortably, actually.
Yeah.
People are dying?
Mm-hmm, yeah. I just slip under the covers, and I get warm and toasty.
Well, I slip under the covers with them,
and I just drift off together.
Ooh, spicy. So, yeah. How many gunshot wounds, what kind of guns do you guys use when you shoot these zombies down?
I use grenades, actually.
Grenades?
Yeah.
Like a real grenade?
I keep grenades on a belt, and...
Isn't that kind of dangerous?
A little dangerous, but I make sure that the pin stays in until I'm ready to use them.
Okay, all right.
It's quite amusing just hitting somebody with a grenade.
Yeah.
They get freaked out, and you're just like, no, pin's
still in, dude. So, can you explain the game to me? What, the rules?
All right, more or less, it's a glorified game of tag.
Okay.
Right? So you've got two teams.
Like freeze tag?
Kind of, not really. You've got the humans on one side who run around with Nerf guns and socks and... kind of weapon.
Oh, so they're not real guns?
No.
Oh, I thought you actually
It'd be much
people.
More amusing, a little more terrifying.
Okay. We'd only be able to play once, though.
Oh, true.
But it'd be an awesome game, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Well, the humans are basically coming out every night to achieve some sort of a mission, and the zombies are the opposing faction, are playing a giant game of tag, trying to reach the humans and tag them before the humans can shoot them with their guns of some sort. So and if a human is tagged by a zombie, they become a zombie.
All right, just quickly, how big is this? Is it just Ball State? A lot of campuses? Is it like a...
Nationwide.
Global?
Completely
is it global?
Yes, it is global.
You've gone global.
Absolutely. It's played on military bases overseas. It's played in universities across the world. It's everywhere.
Wow, it's taken over. Well, thank you guys.
Yeah.
That's humans versus zombies.
You did. He did no research. You told us there'd be zombies.
I thought they looked better than they would.
I questioned his reporting skills. That's all right.
It's okay.
That's fine.
We'll give him some slack this time.
We've got a special interview coming up next, so please stay tuned.
Thank you.
You know, a lot of people know my family. We got a big old family, but, you know, the Salisburys, even though we're popular around Dallas, you know, we are synonymous with violence and alcohol. I mean, have I been drinking since 6 a.m.? Yes. Not a lot of positives, you know, surrounding that. You see, when you have a goat's liver, the alcohol just filters so damn quick, you know, it don't matter. I can drink all day. We're doing some in-field research right now. Now, you're a Ball State student, correct?
Yep, I'm a Ball State student.
All right, great. What do you think about Proposition 18?
I've never heard of it.
Well, that's a great question. We want to get rid of the bell tower, put in an oil rig. Now, what do you think about that?
That's a pretty stupid idea. I don't like it.
What the f*** kind of answer is that? Now, what do you think about Proposition 18?
I'm not gonna say it.
You're gonna say what I tell you. You ready?
Yeah.
Don't f*** up. Proposition 18, what do you think of it?
I really support it, and it's good.
That's all we need. Good. Cut. I met with a couple students today. I really did. F***ing punks. I mean, they were just, how far down can your pants hang on your ass? That's what I want to know. They not have suspenders? Are those out of style? Put the Jonas Brothers in suspenders, and every kid's going to want to have their pants up, you know? They're walking around with the purity rings, you know? That's a dumb idea. Business capital ventures, you know? First thing I ever did when I started dabbling in business was I created a cologne exclusively for males. It was called Whiskey, you know? It was just whiskey with the tilde on the end. We did was we took Jack Daniels and put it in the cologne bottle. Later found out the teens had figured that one out and were buying it and drinking it, so we had to discontinue it in America. We sell it now to Japan. And they think it's exotic. Just Jack Daniels. You know, people say, you know, Buck likes to party. I say yes, you know. I know how to party. I'm a big fan of it. Don't do drugs, though. No, I do not do drugs. I don't believe in it. Growing up, my mama said to me, you do not do drugs. And I don't. I never have. Been drinking since the age of 12, though, so. No!
I don't know.